battery, just trying to get a cool shot of me waking up, even though I'm already awake. Please don't fall. Leander, oh my god.
Please don't fall.
I really tried.
Oh god. Oh god. Hi guys. So yeah, it's been a minute. This is actually the third time I'm filming this video because quite honestly, the past two times that I filmed it were so fucking depressing. And that was just me catching you up on what's been happening in the last month, so... I mean... But yeah, obviously I'm gonna catch you guys up on what's been... Really? Anyways, yeah, I'm obviously gonna catch you guys up on what's been going on. But I'm just happy to be back. I'm happy to be back filming a YouTube video. It's just been, like, everything's fine. I just wanna start the video off by saying everything's fine, I'm fine. My immediate family and friends are fine. It's just been a lot. It's been a month, and I'm sorry I haven't uploaded, but it's just like there was just never a good time. It's not that I didn't want to, and this was definitely not planned, but it's just how it be sometimes. But yeah, I hope you guys are good. I really miss you guys. Yeah, let's get up. 5 minutes. Wow.
Hey?
I'm just really good at making coffee.
You're really good?
Yeah. Say what you just said. When I said I'm really good at making coffee.
That's about the only thing you are at.
Honestly, with the past month, I don't actually know where to start. So I'm not going to just yet.
What the hell do you want?
You haven't seen them in a month.
Hi everybody! Everybody hi! She's accomplished pasta and sauce. She's accomplished how to throw pasta in a bowl and then add a bottle of sauce to it. It's very nice. And a few raw onions. Very good. In 2 years.
You were like,
It was good
last night.
It was.
Yeah, I know it was. The most random lunch, but I swear, it slaps. Guys, I'm watching. Don't take the piss out of my really old TV. I know it's old, but it still works. Anyways, I've been watching On The Verge on Netflix. And honestly, guys, I don't know what's going on yet, but I'm literally like watching a show about 45, 50 year old women and like really enjoying it and relating to them. And I'm 25, so I don't know what that means, but you should go watch it if you haven't watched it yet. Okay, so I'm gonna put some makeup on and catch you guys up with what's been going on. Also guys, I really think I'm gonna cut my hair like short, like this short. So that's kind of a indication of how my life has been recently. I mean, the main thing that's happened, why am I finding this so hard to say? Basically, you guys know that I've said before I'm a hypochondriac. Like, I know people say that a lot. If you don't know what I'm talking about, basically, it's where you're very anxious about health. Well, I'm gonna put the description on the screen because I might not know exactly what it means, but from what I know, obviously I haven't been diagnosed, but I don't see how I'm not hypochondriac, so I'm just gonna say I'm a hypochondriac. Hi, I'm a Legion hypochondriac. But basically, that got really bad this month. So basically for me, when it gets bad, I will literally like feel a symptom, or not even a symptom, like a pain, for example. And literally, like, it sounds dramatic, but I literally think I'm dying. Like, I will Google it. To put it more simply, in the past month, I have diagnosed myself with about 10 terminal conditions. That wasn't the reason that I took time off YouTube. I don't even know what the reason was, but I feel like it all happened at this point for a reason. Because we also had a loss in the family a few weeks ago, which was obviously really sad, and we obviously had, you know, to deal with that kind of thing and go see family and stuff. It was just really sudden. And it didn't feel right to just, I mean, it would have been fine if I'd recorded, it would have been fine if I uploaded, but I didn't want to do it. And it was just, I don't know. It wasn't just our family who obviously went through a loss. It was also like my mom, there was a point, I'm not even joking. My mom was getting like a phone call every few days, hearing about either people she knew or like friends of friends or friends of the family who had sadly passed away. And it was like, again, it's going to sound dramatic, but it's just how I felt. At the time, it felt like, it literally felt like death was chasing us. Not us, I mean, they didn't feel like that, but I felt like it was just, it's a weird, I don't know how to explain it, but that's how I felt. Anyways, obviously my logical brain knows that's just a part of life and it's gonna happen to everyone one day, but there is a part of my brain that is just like, whoa, I can't process death. Like, I can't. No one knows what it's that thing where no one knows what it's gonna be like, but everyone's gonna experience it at some point. And it's like, I can either not think about it at all and be really in the present, or that is literally all I think about. And it's not like a light thing, like I will genuinely think about either illness or people dying around me like 90% of the day if it's really bad. So I think obviously not having YouTube to focus on, but also not wanting to make videos, because it's not really something you want to distract yourself from, you just have to kind of, you know, go through it. And like, so like, even when I'm talking about it, I don't even know how to talk about it, but there was a good few weeks where I was just like literally consumed by it. Like, I literally, it was bad for me, and it was being in like a really anxious state of mind, whatever. I mean, if you don't understand what I'm going through, I'm really happy for you. I really hope you don't, because it's not nice. But yeah, if you're in like a really heightened sense of even just awareness, it can be a shit time, a really shit time. So yeah, there's just a lot of emotion, a lot of tensions building up, and I ended up having a really bad panic attack, a really bad one. I've only had one in my life, and it wasn't as bad as what I had. I basically had it in the shower, of all places. And if you've ever experienced a panic attack, you probably know how scary it can be. Again, if you haven't and you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm so happy for you, and I really hope you never do. But yeah, basically felt awful in the shower, and I kind of knew what was going on, because I mean, I read up about this stuff all the time, because I read up about health all the time. Genuinely, like, it just took it completely out of me, and this was a few weeks ago now, because I was initially planning to come back to YouTube like, well, after all the kind of family stuff and that whole time. But yeah, then that happened and I was like, okay, should probably deal with this. And as I said, I've never had one like that before, but it totally just mentally and physically took it out of me. It's basically, I mean, it makes sense. It's basically like your body reacting to perceived danger. Obviously there wasn't any actual danger near me, but in my head I was obviously really focused on health and things that could go wrong, and things were just building up for so long that obviously my body was just like, okay, we don't know how to cope with it, so we're just gonna give you a nice little panic attack. But yeah, I'm gonna go into more depth about it on my podcast, because it's definitely something I want to speak about more. But yeah, that's basically why I haven't really been filming. And to be fair, I think a big reason why it got so bad is because I wasn't doing anything else to distract myself. But at the same time, I'm glad I had to kind of face it. So yeah, sorry to get so deep on you, but I just thought, listen, we are honest around here, and I didn't want to just like jump back into videos without explaining what the hell happened, because it was an intense month. But that's basically what's been going on. I hope you guys are good. I've really like genuinely missed you guys so much. I'm so ready to make videos again, make podcasts again. So yeah, I'm happy I took the break, and I'm happy that I actually like want to do it again. So yeah, if you guys are going through anything tough, or it feels like one thing's coming up after the other, it does slow down, it does settle down. Also, some positives from when I've been away. I finished my marketing course, so that's good. I guess not making videos and stuff gave me a bit of time to focus on that and properly finish it. So yeah, I had to do like an exam and a final project. But yeah, that's all done and dusted. Hi, Dad.
Hi, Sarah.
Hi.
Is your mum still got the two cod in the fridge freezer?
I was going to make the pasta.
Okay, then make that.
If you want.
I'll make cod next week.
Okay.
Alright then, I'll see you there for
the. Okay, see you later, love you, bye.
Yeah,
anyways, I'm now ready with 8 minutes to spare. That now happens to me. What is the world? Does anyone else get nervous before Zoom meetings? Why am I so nervous? No, as if my password isn't working. No. Why did you just sign me out like that? Okay. Do I put my AirPods in? No. Do I join early? Or is that... No, I'm gonna wait. It's 59. F it, I'm gonna join. Zoom isn't working, I have to do a WhatsApp call now. What the hell? Why is this not going smooth? Hello. Sorry about that, I don't know what happened. Okay, Dad wants to do a card trick for everyone. Hold on.
Okay, first of all, it's not a card trick.
What is it then?
I'm going to just want to look into telepathy.
Okay.
So, pack of cards, and I'm going to show it like that. Okay. And then I'm just going to pick one card, and all I want you to do, and first of all, I'll just...
Tell them when to start thinking.
Not yet.
Oh.
I'll send it to them. Wait. Okay, so this is a serious experiment. Don't take it as a joke, okay? So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be sending signals across the ether. Here it goes. Wait.
Did you just say the ether?
Yes. Some of you might visualize this, some of you might hear it.
If you want to put your hand on your head, then do that too.
Yeah. All right, it's not a joke. My visualizer skills not great. If you're a visualizer, you might not be picking up that well. But my audio skills are better. So I'm sending it, saying it, and visualize. Saying it, visualizing. Saying it. Right, just keep quiet now. Okay, done.
Well, I'm going to say what I think it is.
Okay, you say.
King of Diamonds.
You got the colour, all right? If anybody said Ace of Diamonds...
Oh, I was close!
So there you go. That's my... There'll be regular telepathic experiments on Alicia's YouTube video from me. All those who want to take part, please do so. It's a serious scientific experiment, by the way. I'm not joking.
Right.
Peace out.
I have to make dinner now. I'm good at one dish and maybe make it every week. Something weird that happened while I was not making videos, I had like three people that I like knew but didn't really speak to all the time or had lost contact with ask for help, like about social media. It was really weird how it happened because obviously I wasn't really making videos, but they were asking for like advice and stuff. So yeah, that kind of encouraged me to start doing it again, and it kind of re-sparked my passion for it again. And also, which was so weird again, I saw a subscriber in, was it Foot Locker, Foot Asylum? I think it was Foot Locker. I was literally just shopping in town with my friend. I saw a subscriber, so hi, if you're watching, you know who you are. Genuinely, I was so caught off guard. Like, obviously I've seen people before. Also, I've seen quite a few of you in Coventry, so I feel like YouTube does a really good job at tailoring content to where you live. Kind of creepy, but anyway, yeah, I saw her in Foot Locker and it genuinely made my day because obviously I haven't really been out that much recently because of COVID and stuff. But yeah, that I think was the final like push to start making videos again because she was just so nice. And yeah, that's why I do this, to connect with people and to help people and to give people something to relate to, because I don't know, I've just been struggling with the whole why am I making videos and stuff. But I guess for me anyway, it's not so much about what I'm putting out. It's more about just, I don't know. I guess just being like someone for you guys to relate to. Because it's all online, even though I speak to you guys all the time on like Instagram and through comments and stuff, it's hard to put it into real life because obviously it's not in person. But then when you actually see people who watch your videos and stuff and, you know, say like, your videos have helped me through this or have helped me pass my test, it's just like it genuinely makes it all worth it. Like, that is the reason that I do it. So yeah, that's basically how the past month's been. I appreciate you guys being patient with me. I appreciate you if you've come back to watch this video. Sorry I've been gone for so long, but honestly, when it comes to things like that, it's just best to take some time out and just like refocus and remember why you're doing stuff. So yeah, I'm back now and you're not getting rid of me. Thank you for watching, guys. I'll be back soon with another video. I love you so much. I hope you're all good. But yeah, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one.